The nice thing with Mammoet is, if you can dream it, we can build it. It really is like that. We're here at the Fawley site with the Focus 30. As you can see, this area is really tight.
The reactor head is a huge piece of equipment which weighs nearly 400 tons.
We were like down to inches. We really had nothing.
Maneuvering it in that space was a big logistical challenge.
We've been able to let Exxon continue to run the plant while we got the crane ready for the major maintenance event.
Ensuring that the client can continue on with their program. I don't think you would have done this job with another crane.
Using the Focus 30, we've been able to overcome that challenge really successfully.
The Fawley refinery is the largest refinery in the UK, so we are a vital part of the UK infrastructure in providing the fuels and the products that society in the south of England needs for everyday life. We've shut down a large part of the refinery for 6 or 7 weeks to do some essential maintenance. Now, the largest part of that maintenance program is replacing the upper part of the reactor, which is the main part of the cat cracker. Most of Fawley Refinery was built after the Second World War in the late 1940s, and then it's expanded over the years. So moving major pieces of equipment is very, very challenging for us because the space around the units is very limited. So yeah, a big logistical challenge, and that's why we engaged Mammoet to help us with that challenge.
Because of the space limitations and other factors, it came that the Focus 30 was the actual right crane for the job. Building a crawler crane or PTC type crane
would have been a challenge, as we would have had to shut down quite a lot of different areas on site to put the boom across it. Because we've used the Focus 30, we can build into the sky and keep ourselves confined to a much smaller space.
They don't want to shut down or take product out of these lines. They want to keep their plant running as long as possible. The Focus 30 is the only crane that can fully eliminate that sort of working over live equipment.
We have a roadway here that we had to keep open the entire build. We also had a roadway along here that we were able to keep open. Everything came in. I mean, it was really tight. Everything was right down to the wire, but it all came in. And here we are now sitting in front of this crane.
Before the event and straight afterwards, in order to run the cat cracker, we need a lot of catalyst. And that catalyst comes in by road tankers. So allowing us to keep those roads open around the unit meant that we could keep operating until the very last minute and set up the crane without disturbing the operation.
There was quite a few activities going on while we were mobilizing, and they were able to just continue on. So there was no disruption while we were building the Focus. Our widest piece was 4.5 meters. The gates were 4.6, so there wasn't much space to come in, but everything fit, everything went into the unit and got it put into the crane.
So the space has been very tight on site. Getting the mobile in and even the room it had to work when we were building the crane was challenging.
Yeah, there's obviously space issues, but the idea with the Focus is that it just stays in its own area. So really those space issues, once we've defined our area, we don't need any extra. I don't think you would have done this job with another crane. This is just a Focus job.
Because the Focus has got such a large boom and reach, it's helped not bringing in other cranes where the Focus can reach. Undertake some of the smaller lifts as well as the larger ones.
The Focus 30 is a heavy lift, self-erecting pedestal crane, essentially. It's only type of crane in the world that can do this.
The Focus sits on a 14 by 14 outrigger spread. The build area is roughly 27 by 40.
We used a 500 ton mobile crane in one position to fully build it from start to finish.
Yes, we stay within that build area the whole time.
And it just builds itself straight upwards. It's amazing, really.
There's no need to have an area designated to boom the crane down if you have high winds. We can handle 65 meters a second. We can take a Cat 5 Hurricane. That's what you wanted, right? Behind the crane, we had other obstructions. The counterweights actually swung on top of these. We were able to see everything in Move 3D, and that's really what gave us the confidence to go through this.
So Move 3D allows us to see in areas sometimes it's not possible to engineer from drawings what spaces we have, and stuff like boom clashes, clearances from pipe racks, we can accurately see before we put the equipment onto site that we can clear everything and everything works.
The technology and the software that Mammoet have is pretty spectacular.
In this case, we had the whole site 3D laser scanned, and with the use of Move 3D, we were able to create a 3D model of the site.
We could then bring that to ExxonMobil Fawley using a VR headset. We then showed them exactly what their site would look like when the Focus was built and in position, ready to do their maintenance.
Being able to put the headset on and look around how the crane would look, you know, in 360 degrees was really, it felt amazing. You know, you could look down, you could look up and really see and get a feel for how it would operate in a tight space.
We're able to show them actually how much space we're going to take up on site and actually help visualize it for the client.
And give them a sense of comfortability that everything works and all our checks have been made, and that just how close everything was on the site to different components.
Using the Move 3D, the simulation of the crane, as I said, to help us ensure that it would all work smoothly and it wouldn't impact our other equipment, was a vital part of preparing for the lift. And ultimately, it proved to be absolutely spot on.
Move 3D is, it's once you've got the model set up, it's so much easier to do checks live in front of the client. So the client may just say like, oh, John, what's the maximum crane I can position in this area? I need to lift something above the reactor head, and I can literally just drag and drop a crane into that position, show them how tight it is and the restrictions.
The crane had to move very close to other equipment. So all of that software allows us with Mammoet to model how it will work, and really it was inch perfect.
Usually that sort of checks would normally take a few hours at least probably. This, you can do it in minutes.
And it just gives us the confidence that when we were coming to site, everything has been thoroughly checked and that we could undertake the work in some really, really tight areas, knowing that we had the confidence to do that. In the end, it saves time, because in the past we've done projects where you take certain aspects of steel work and pipe work out to maybe give yourself a little bit more room. You've got the confidence to know that you can only take out the minimum and still achieve the same process of getting the job done.
Other projects like this and we thought they were tight. This one's definitely tighter than those.
We had a little bit more space on the last project. This project seems to be a lot smaller than last time, and I think the next projects that we are looking at are even tighter, but anything is possible.
You can imagine bringing a crane of this size to a site is a challenge, because it involves a lot of truck movements, a lot of equipment, so doing that quickly and in a small space was really, really vital to us. And that's where Mammoet have delivered.